Greetings in the name of Jesus Christ. This is the day the Lord has made. In this day, I rejoice and I'm glad in it. Today, I want to encourage someone in this place, someone who's watching us. Welcome, everyone, those that are watching us from different platforms. Today, I just want to encourage you not to give up, not to throw the towel, not to stop. Continue moving. Because life is a journey. Life is a journey. We are moving from one place to another. Now, today I just want to, I want us to read from Numbers 33, from verse 1 to 9. These are the journeys of the children of Israel, who went out of the land of Egypt by their armies under the hand of Moses and Aaron. That means they were under the leadership of Moses and Aaron. Now Moses wrote down the starting point of their journeys at the command of the Lord. And these are the journeys according to their starting points. They departed from Ramses in the first month, on the 15th day of the first month, on the day after the Passover, the children of Israel went out with boldness in the sight of all the Egyptians. For the Egyptians were burying all their firstborns, whom the Lord had killed among them. Also, on their gods, the Lord had executed judgment. Then the children of Israel moved from Ramses and camped at Succoth. They departed from Succoth and camped at Etham, which is at the edge of the wilderness. They moved from Etham and turned back to Pi Hahiroth, which is east of Baal Zephon, and they camped near Migdol. They departed from before Hahiroth and passed through the midst of the sea into the wilderness, went 3 days' journey in the wilderness of Etham and camped at Marah. They moved from Marah and came to Elim. At Elim were 12 springs of water and 70 palm trees. So they camped there. Now, as you continue reading, you will see that they kept on camping and moving. Camping and moving. It's a journey. That is the journey that I would like us to compare it to the journey of our lives. Now, if you want to finish right this year, you want to finish in style, you want to make sure that you achieve something this year, you have to keep moving. Don't give up. Don't throw the towel. We are to learn from the journeys of the children of Israel as they journeyed from Egypt to the promised land. You will see that there are many movements between your Egypt and your promised land. Many movements. There are many stops. There are many camps. There are many starting points. Therefore, let's learn from them and see how they did it and be encouraged this morning. Never, never give up. Tell your neighbor and say, never give up. Keep moving. Don't throw the towel. Now, many people make a mistake by stopping when times are tough. They forget that tough times never last. Only tough people will last. Now, when the tough gets going or when the heat gets hotter, people want to pull out and leave and be discouraged and make sure that they throw away everything they have started. Now, this morning, I want to encourage all of us that the ideas that you have, the ideas that God gave you, the things that God helped you to start, keep moving, don't give up. Others give up to an extent that they want to commit suicide. This morning, I want to say to all of you, never even think of killing yourself. Don't commit suicide. Just move and move and move until you reach your promised land. It's just a season. It's passing. It's true that many people lost jobs. Many people are retrenched because companies are not doing well. It's true that businesses are not doing well. I was in a mall somewhere in the east there. I saw how many shops are empty now because the businesses are not doing well. But I want to say, don't give up. Don't throw the towel. Keep doing something and you will see there's a time of breakthrough that will come your way. Be encouraged. Even churches are not doing well. Some churches are not doing well. Some are still closed. Some are starting afresh. There are many dynamics around our lives these days. But I want to encourage all of us. Let's continue moving and pushing and moving and pushing. We will reach our destiny. Now, we have read from Numbers 33 from verse 1 to 9. And that scripture captures the movement of the children of Israel from one point to another. There are things that I want you to note there. Note that Moses noted the starting points. Moses noted that when they camped, the day they leave, he will write down that we were here. And then they will move and camp somewhere. When they leave, he will write down. He will know that, okay, we are now in this position and we are leaving. This is the date. And also note the following, the statement that says, went out in boldness in front of Egyptians. Israelites went out in boldness in front of their enemies. And then another thing I want you to underline and note is they passed through the midst of the Red Sea. And then the other thing, they camped at Marah. They camped at Marah. They moved from one place to another and kept on moving and kept on moving, even if the moving was tough. It's true, others amongst them, they even criticized Moses and Aaron. They wanted to go back, but Moses was bold. Aaron was bold. He kept on encouraging them and told them, let's move on. Now, this morning, I want to encourage you. Let's move on. Let's not give up. Let us not throw the towel. Now, the story of the movement of children of Israel is the story of the movement of us as people. It's a journey of our lives. When you set out in life, you don't set out in one point and reach the destination the next day. You keep moving, you meet resistance, you meet challenges. There are times when you want to really get out and close everything and you are finished. You tell yourself, I can't do it anymore. But today I want to encourage you, keep moving, keep going, never throw the towel, because there are lots and lots of movement in life, lots and lots of challenges in life. Even as we are talking, food is now expensive, petrol is expensive, people lost jobs, people's businesses are closed, churches are not doing well, everybody is just struggling, and then few people are doing well. But today I want to encourage every one of us that let's hold hands and move together and not throw out the towel. Life is made up of many, many movements, but there are five things that I want us to note. The first one is Moses took note of their starting points. If you are going to see progress in your life, you have to take note of your starting point. Take note of where you are. In verse 2, the Bible says he wrote down or noted their starting points of their journeys. He always noted, this is where I am starting from. And then, so that when there are challenges, you don't look back and say, but I'm doing nothing. If you have noted where you are starting, when there are challenges, when you look back, you can see that, no, even if I moved a little, but there was progress, there was movement. Note where you are now, so that every step that you take forward, you can see that I am moving forward. Now, Moses always noted and he wrote, this is where I'm starting. Not only the starting points, but the starting points. Not only the starting point, but the starting points. It means where they are starting, he wrote. And then they camped, they rested. When they start again, he wrote again. He noted where they are starting. Now, every time they settled, he noted where they settled. And when they moved, he noted the conditions they were starting in, so he could determine their progress. It is important for you to keep noting where you are so that you can determine your progress. If you are going to appreciate your movement, you need to do what Moses did. Note your starting points. Where are you now? And then look back. Where were you last year? Where were you in 2019? Where were you in 2015? Now, the reason why you should note your starting point is because it helps you to measure your progress and to appreciate where God has taken you to. If you don't know, even when you have moved, you won't appreciate, you won't even realize that you have moved. If you hear me, shout amen. Now, many of us may say 2020 was a wasted year. You may feel that way because you did not take note of your starting point. And then if you can really think deep, you can see that you did well, you did move, there was progress in your life. How have you progressed? If you don't take note of your starting points, you won't appreciate that you have progressed. Now, in life, there's a starting point and you aim at reaching a certain point. Now, between your starting point and your final point, there are many movements that you will do. Therefore, keep on noting what is happening in your life, where you are now, so that when you have moved, even if it's just two steps, when you have moved, then you can say, it's true, I have moved, and you appreciate it, and you thank God for that step, because life, it's a transition. You are moving every day from one step to another. The second thing that you must do is be able to move in the sight of your enemies. Be able to move in the sight of your enemies. When the Israelites left Egypt, they moved in front of their enemies, in front of the Egyptians. They were watching them. Now, take off in the sight of your enemies. Verse 3 says, the children of Israel went with boldness. When you take off, when you move in front of your enemies, move with boldness. This verse gives the impression that the Egyptians were looking, they were angry, they were in a bad mood because the Israelites, their servants, their slaves were moving away and they were busy burying their children. Now, do the same. Move with boldness. Don't look down upon yourself. You are great. You are not the tail, you are the head. You are not beneath, you are above. Move like you know who you are. Then how do you do that? Don't be intimidated by the presence of the enemy forces. Israel left Egypt under the angry watch of Egyptians. You may never have an encouragement from those watching you. They will want you to stay. They will want you to remain with them. They will want you to keep serving them. But be bold, take a step, and move forward. Some will threaten you. Some will depress you with their stories of their failures. Some will hate you for even thinking of moving from where you are. Some will think you don't have what it takes. You don't have the talent. Some will think you won't make it without them. They will even point at you and say, you are nothing. You won't make it without them. But move out with boldness. Rise up and walk. And there are times that you will need encouragement. They may not encourage you. Learn to encourage yourself like David. One day David went to war to Ziklag with his armies. When he came back, they realized that the enemy came and burnt their houses, took their children, took their wives, and they left that place. And David had to encourage himself in the Lord, because even his armies, even his soldiers, they wanted to stone him. They were saying, it is you who took us to war. Now look at what has happened. Now today I want to encourage you that when no one is encouraging you, encourage yourself in the Lord. Find something strong to stand on. Find a verse to stand on. And know that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You are not weak, you are strong. You are not the tail, you are the head. You are not beneath, you are above. You are not weak, you are strong. Keep moving. Keep moving. I'm here to say to you, keep moving. Keep moving. Don't stop. Don't throw the towel. Don't give up. The Lord is with you. You will live and not die and declare the purposes of God. Put your trust in God. The Bible says, cursed is the man who put his trust in another man. Therefore, put your trust in God and move on with strength. Move on with power. Move on with authority. Move on with confidence. Move on knowing who you are. Move on knowing who your God is. If God be for us, who can be against us? When the enemy comes like a flood, the Lord raises a standard. Even when you walk through the shadow of the valley, if you walk through the shadow, you know, when things are tough, when you sense death, when you are threatened, know that the Lord is with you. The valley of death, know that the Lord is with you. And one day your cup will run over. It will overflow. You won't be blessed only, but you will be a blessing to others. Now this morning I want you to be encouraged. Don't give up. Note your starting points and move on in the sight of your enemies. May the good God bless you. You are great, and I believe we will see you growing and moving higher and higher and higher. You are great. This is Bishop Dr. J. Tause. You are blessed. See you again this time next week.